Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining us here on Horizon. Well, advocates of wind power are celebrating the survival of a tax credit many thought dead on arrival. The credit survived the high-stakes debate in Washington over taxes and spending in the so-called fiscal cliff drama that began the new year. Advocates argue that continuing the tax credit is critical to the emerging wind industry that here in Oklahoma has seen tremendous growth, and with that, some growing pains. Joining me now is our Keela Kellen.
Well, Rob, wind developers certainly were nervous at the end of last year, but with the extension of the tax credit has allowed them to continue their work with federal aid for at least the next year.
Spinning blades of wind turbines have become a common sight across western Oklahoma. Shannon Farrell is an agricultural law specialist and specializes in wind energy.
As we saw in the entirety of 2012, the possibility that the tax credit was going to expire, that naturally gets lots of people worried in the industry because that has lots of ripple effects. Lots of people hear about the tax credit and they assume, okay, well, that's going to result in layoffs in the manufacturing sector. And clearly that's true. But that affects the whole pipeline of wind project development.
Because of the uncertainty over the tax credit, there was a flurry of activity in 2012 to get the newly built wind farms online before the end of the year, activity that could slow growth in 2013.
That doesn't mean they're not going to be moving projects through pipeline development. It just means that we will most likely see a reduced number of projects actually being constructed and producing power, you know, over the next probably year.
Kyla McNabb is a wind energy specialist for the Oklahoma Department of Commerce.
We are really a national leader. We're definitely in the top five states in that we are going to be reaching 15% of our energy coming from wind power.
And while the tax credit extension is only for 1 year, Farrell says it will still help.
The tax credit has been really important for wind because wind, like most of your other utility industries, is a fairly small margin business. So in many cases, you'll find that a wind energy project is breaking even on their sale of power and that tax credit may actually be providing the profit margin for that. So that's really what's driving the development of those projects. And a lot of things have helped Oklahoma's wind industry grow. I mean, number one, go outside. We've got a wind resource. It's really spectacular compared to other states. But the tax credit still is an important part of that, and we've seen incredible growth in the state as a result of that and several other factors.
And with all this growth, turbines are being seen popping up closer to some city limits.
But as the industry continues to grow, more and more we're going to see wind turbines getting into areas that are more densely populated, and that means that there's more opportunity for neighbor conflicts. And so that's one of the reasons that I think the industry and states and communities are going to have to start being really proactive and putting in place, you know, legal systems and regulations to make sure that we've accounted for all those interests, things like setbacks of turbines from roads, from property lines, from houses, things of that sort, to kind of identify some of those issues before they get to be problems.
Residents near the town of Piedmont are opposed to the idea of a new wind farm because they fear their homes could lose property value.
My concern is, as our property values fall from being near these turbines, our ad valorem taxes will fall. It'll offset whatever we get from having the turbines there. So I don't think it's going to be a long-term benefit at all.
And while a common sight across much of rural Oklahoma, urban residents feel that there is a difference when they are erected closer to town.
The aesthetic issue, some people like to look at them, some people don't. There are some concerns about noise or about shadow flicker. Whenever the blades pass between you and the sun, you kind of get a blinking effect, so to speak. And in terms of the litigation that we've seen both in Oklahoma and in other states, the aesthetic issues, the view, the shadow flicker, and the noise have been the issues that we've seen the most conflict about.
We're not a rural community in the middle of nowhere. We're a commuter county on the east side of Canadian County, and people have lots of options within 30 minutes of Oklahoma City of where to live. They don't have to live near a turbine.
Concerns that so far have not slowed an energy source that keeps growing, one turn at a time.
All Although concerns continue to rise with the growing wind industry, wind power continues to be one of the nation's leading energy sources.
So with all these towers now up and running, how much wind energy are we generating here in the state?
According to Dr. Farrell, Oklahoma last year produced about 31 megawatts of energy, which could roughly power about 31,000 homes.
Wow, and as I also understand, Oklahoma State University, where you interviewed Dr. Farrell, is now, as of January 1, using about 65% of their energy. It's coming from a wind farm near Blackwell. Thanks for that story, Keela.
You're welcome, Rob.
When we return, our Andy Barth shows us what it's like to go to work 300 feet up in the air.